Shalom from Israel and happy Passover to you all. My name is Ronny Simon. Another broadcast from the country that would like to tell you what happens in Israel over the last couple of days and also to touch on something which is not related directly to the coronavirus, indirectly yes, but not directly, and that will speak about one of the most popular traditions in the country which is taking place by the Western world. And it's called the blessing of the priests or the Aaronic benediction. But first, a little update about what happens in Israel. It's Passover and usually a holiday that people get together for large meals and large family meetings. Friends and family will get together. And it's interesting to know that although we are divided and we are dispersed all around the world, the Jewish people, we all know what keeps us together. We all know what is in common to all of us. We all celebrate the holidays at the same time, and there was a sense of family and unity to know that all around the world, in the very same moment, well, not the same, the very same day, the Jewish people are celebrating the Feast of Passover and the Seder meal, as we are commanded in the book of Exodus chapter 12. So it's a big holiday in the country, but this year is so unusual and so different than it was so far. Israel is reaching the climax of the pandemic of the coronavirus, and the next few weeks are going to be critical to tell how we are in the right direction, or maybe that will take much longer to overcome that disease. Today, the efforts are focusing on two main centers. Number one, the ultra-Orthodox neighborhoods in Jerusalem and the town of Bnei Brak, which is predominantly ultra-Orthodox outside Tel Aviv. And the second focal point will be senior citizens' homes, which are also a major problem over the last few weeks. That's where the infection has the highest rate, as it is in other countries around the world. The elderly are not safe, and they are more vulnerable in that regard. Israel has taken some measures, especially for Passover, because the last experience that we had with a large gathering without keeping those restrictions was a month ago, the holiday of Purim. Back then, people were totally unaware of what is it that we are facing, especially in the ultra-Orthodox world, and therefore partying together and celebrated together, that was the main trigger for the high rate of infection. We've learned a lesson. And for that reason, there is almost a complete lockdown. We cannot commute from town to town because the roads are blocked. Inside the communities we can, but only there is absolute necessity to seek medical attention or to go to the groceries. And that's the way it's going to be until Sunday morning. It is Wednesday evening that we celebrate the Passover, and that's going to be for a few days, and maybe that will help. In the town of Bnei Brak, for example, when there was a high rate of infection, Israel offered people that thought that they may be infected not to infect others to leave the town and to go to places specially prepared for them, but the cooperation was very, very minor. For the ultra-Orthodox families, Passover is a major celebration, and now to celebrate this holiday with the family was maybe too much to bear. So we'll see in the next few days, was it a problem or whether the rate of infection is going to increase, and that will tell us how to behave in the future as well. We need to wait for a few more days or maybe a week or two to come to some conclusions. Another way to try to control people and to restrict people was by setting roadblocks, and there was one set on the highway that goes straight up to Jerusalem, more than one. And the idea was this, to stop vehicles and to stop public buses and check the people inside. Because if a public bus carries more than 20 passengers, it will be a violation of those restrictions and the driver will be heavily fined. 5,000 shekels of a fine, it's quite a lot of money in Israeli currency. And also, people that thought maybe to be smarter than the restrictions are and to go and celebrate with family and friends, well, they were stopped as well. Cars were stopped and the trunk was checked. And if you check your ID and the place that you're residing was not Jerusalem and you carry some baggage with you, you were asked to stop, turn around and make your way back to your home. Well, we did stop a couple of thousands of people from going to Jerusalem for no real need except for celebrating together. And maybe that was effective. Again, the next couple of days after Passover will be critical to understand, are these measures useful, yes or no? So these are some of the measures that we were taking recently. And it's interesting to note, and now we speak a little bit about Passover, the way it's celebrated in Israel for this year, that we were totally were under curfew from last evening until 7 a.m. this morning. Nobody was permitted to leave the homes. It made me smile because when you go to Exodus chapter 12, verse 22, that's exactly what Moses ordered the Israelites. Do not leave your home until morning. Well, maybe for the first time and the last time. In 3,500 years or so, we did exactly what we were told to do in the scriptures, not to leave the homes from the Seder meal or the Passover meal until next morning. There was a tradition in Israel, which is relatively new, started in 1970, which echoes the biblical commandment, and this is a large gathering by the Western Wall, and the priests, the Kohanim, are blessing the nation. Well, blessing the nation is a commandment that you find in the book of Numbers chapter 6. If you go to verses 22 to 26, you read the commandment that was given to Aaron and his sons to bless the Israelites. And you all know the blessing. I'm sure that you know the words. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord shine his face upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance towards you and gives you peace. Well, we say it in synagogues every day, almost every day for certain occasions. This prayer is being said by Jews for different reasons, the different occasions as well. But ever since the temple was destroyed, it was not stated publicly as it is now since 1970. It's a very emotional experience. And by the Western Wall, tens of thousands of people are getting together. And all those who are priests and the Kohanim, and we know who they are because we have the records. And even the modern science is helping to relate these people together by DNA studies. So the Kohanim are getting closer to the Western Wall, turn around to the people, and there is a leader who leads the whole ceremony, and he is reading every word, and the Kohanim or the priests are repeating the word, and people are listening very carefully, and only after the praise over a huge amen coming from 50 to 60,000 people, that's quite an emotional celebration. Now, what we do by the Western Wall usually is also biblical, because if you go to the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 30, verse 27, the Bible speaks about the days of King Hezekiah. The nation gets together to celebrate Passover, and the Bible tells us very clearly that the priests and the Levites stood up to bless the whole nation, and the whole nation was blessed by them, and they did that to please God, and God heard the blessing in heavens, his dwelling place. So we did not do that for centuries upon centuries, not having the temple. And the first time it's done publicly, repeating no doubt that procedure that was done in the temple is from 1970 by the Western Wall, a very moving gesture and a very nice part of the holiday and one of the highlights of Passover. Today, unfortunately, due to our circumstances, there's nobody by the Western Wall, absolutely nobody. Today, I guess that every family will have to do that by themselves. And in every family in the Jewish world, the father will bless his sons and his daughters and his wife and the whole household, although he may not be a priest. But everybody can do that under unusual circumstances to have the blessing of the priesthood. Because if you get to the synagogue and there's no priest that happens to be there and there's no guarantee, then the Levites can do the blessing. And if there are no Levites, the Israelites, the commoners can also do that. And therefore we can do that in our homes and we don't have to have this large gathering. So let me bless you once again with the Aaronic benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord shine his face upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance toward you and gives you peace. I do want to wish all of you a happy Resurrection Sunday, and may God richly bless you from Israel. Thank you.